requested our help, so that's where we're going next.
Flying gunner on Overwatch is easier to hit because it doesn't break line of sight and has plus aim. Yeah, that's true. Problem is, it's much more vulnerable, right? And squad sight gunners, they don't have, you can't Overwatch in squad sight range, so they have to be in range regularly, and they can't, and they only have 5 tiles, unlike the sniper, which has infinite tiles, right? So I don't really like having vulnerable gunners. I don't really have, like, vulnerable characters at all, because you don't want to just be run up and one-shot by a Muton Elite, or a Mectoid, or anything else. Edge of the map. I honestly don't recognize this map from this position, which I ought to. I've undoubtedly played it a million times, but I don't really know where I am.
On the move.
Nothing. Okay. Let's push up temporarily. Squad fight, Plasma Dragon's amazing, and Javelin Rockets, they're out of range. Maybe. I don't have a lot of double tap, you can't move. Plus, if you do Overwatch Gunner, why are you taking double tap? You weren't ready for anything. But possibly the Rocketeer, Javelin Rocketeer, that's not a bad idea. That would do line of sight pretty well. I do have one Javelin Rocketeer, I could try that with Flying Armor at some point if I really wanted to. Where the hell is the ship? I'm looking into sunlight again. I can't see a fucking thing, so I have no real idea where I am on the map. It kind of looks like that back corner if you approach it from this side. Is it? I don't know. Tired of grinding small, medium UFOs. I'm just not in the mood for it right now.
Moving out.
Good, didn't aggro. Let's see what's over here. Probably the Muton Elite pack, but it could be the Mectoid pack.
Eyes open.
Alright, now I know where we are. It's a nasty pack. Tell me, you 4 Muton Elites and a Mectoid? It's really fucking nasty. Especially with this cover situation. Might actually be beyond the ability of this group to handle. With no, with no, whatever it is on this squad. Pathfinder. Sure how I can engage this pack, this group. Ooh, maybe I could do something with the shadow grenade. That might work. Maybe not stabilize steady. Did we get Overwatches at all? One kind of shitty Overwatch.
They're moving to flank.
That's pretty bad. Alright, what is this? Indestructible cover, destructible cover, destructible cover. So we can maybe kill two of them. Maybe three even. I just don't know if we have the damage to do it. So, alright. Let's stop thinking and start killing for a moment. Would have liked to have a shredder over here. Oh, what do you mean? Blocked. Why is it blocked? Don't be blocked. Get those trees out of the way. Got one of the trees, but not both. Alright, can we crit that? Yeah, see, I'm in range of too many things in this sniper. This is scary, his position. It's a really uncomfortable position for the squad. The squad is not strong enough to kill these things quick enough. Still be on Overwatch in there.
Moving out. Damn it, missed the target.
Not have high enough damage for this. the other one go? There's two down here somewhere. I see the one right there. Where's the other one? We're both in Overwatch too. Hey, we have a lot of heat to deal with this guy. We need to move a tile. Problem is, I want to take two shots from this position with the gunner. I mean, I can move him a tile, but as soon as I move him, I'm getting shot at. I suppose I'm only getting shot at by the mechtoid if I move there, but that's pretty nasty still. I don't want to suppress to get rid of that, and I need to move other players. Problem is, I need to run two Overwatches on Tang, which is really unpleasant. And especially since I wanted to move over here and actually use the scout to get rid of the Overwatch down here. I suppose I'm going to be precisioning the mechtoid, and I think I'm going to be shreddering everything over here that I can. So, Rocketeer's behind cover. Man, this line of sight on these rockets are really sad. Right there, I guess. Okay, it didn't shred the one I wanted, it didn't shred the Mutant as well, it only shredded the mech. The mech can probably be soloed by this guy, but I gotta find him a spot. He needs to have Blubin as a spot, or Wick spot. I could step aside. That probably line of sight's right there. Is this the gunner? Yeah, okay. So if we were to move here, one tile, I'm gonna save his action for a minute, I'm probably gonna battle scan in a moment. So move Kondrasiak, one tile. And have shots there. Okay, leaves it at 2 health. Grenade. It's not a bad use of a grenade. I kind of want to kill his cover with the grenade instead. Alright, I could smoke here. And have a shot there. Nice. Okay, it's the mechtoid down. There's my alien grenade in here. Cover. A little bit. Or possibly the sniper here now. Only a 62. Why the fuck is it only a 62? Counts him in low defense relative to this position. Alright, well maybe Lobinez can kill him with two shots. 14. Alright. Two left. And they're in positions to flank me, I think. Alright, I need to see them. I think they're both in Overwatch. There's the other one. They are both there. We were to go there and shoot twice and kill one of them, for sure. Problem is, what about the other one? What stops him from just killing Gorby? I'm not going to be able to see with the sniper. The sniper's going to be out of that entirely. So it's only going to be the scout and the assault. Still, I think that's better than them taking shots on us. Okay. Elite Sentry has covering fire. elite. It's not. There's the scout. Go here. There might not have sight. Everything else a little bit slow. It's flanked. That ought to have sight, right? Go there. Okay, there's the shot I wanted to get rid of. Okay. Question is, what do we do about this guy? I can shoot him, but it doesn't necessarily stop anything. I can overwatch and see if he'll just like sprint, but he might run to there. What if he dashes though? A dash would be good. Let's overwatch. And overwatch here. We can get pretty heavily hit here. Oh, but if he runs next to close combat specialist, it could be pretty good. It won't kill him. It can do a lot of damage. He ran to no cover and shot me in no cover. What a fucking prick. Look at that. Runs to no cover and shoots me? What happened to the AI trying to take cover when they were flanked? What happened to that? It's my second assault to get wounded on this. Yeah, you don't dash to cover when you're flanked. You're still flanked. I mean, he's still flanked by the scout. He didn't even try to get to cover. The fuck? It's pretty bullshit. The AI doesn't care about cover if the alien has innate defense. That's still pretty bullshit. Alright, well, I guess we didn't lose a guide from it, but it seems kind of bullshit. I mean, we knew it was a slightly risky position, but I figured with the double flank that it would move to a position of cover, and the only position of cover it was going to be able to get to was a position of cover that it had to sprint to, so it wouldn't be able to shoot me. That was my thought process. We're lucky we had the armor we did, I guess, because that was within one health of dying. That's kind of an ugly pack for this group. Finally. Kind of bullshit. I couldn't leave those two mutants here though with grenades and the rest of it. Any position they took would be flanking my whole group, and it's only light smoke. I mean, we're gonna get hit really hard if we left two Muton Elites shoot. And in light smoke, in light cover like that, with only light smoke, it's entirely possible for a Muton to walk up and either grenade everybody or shoot one guy, and the next Muton walk up and shoot the same guy and kill him. So we needed to do something about alleviating that position, but frustrating. I don't like this portion. I don't like the start location on this map either. Not real good for us. I'm rolling. Rub the stern on it, you wimp.
Yes, Commander.
You know, this is where flashbangs would have been useful if I had them spread out a little bit more. As I said, perhaps we'll involve a little bit more. I mean, we're so used to just suppressing and then dense smoking and being okay, but I pretty much stopped suppressing at this point in the game because it's just better to kill things. It might be nice to have some AoE removal, like flashbangs back again. I don't feel like they're very useful in the mid-game when you're facing mostly Cyberdyst and Mectoids. But once you start seeing Muton Elites and Heavy Floaters, they become a little bit more useful again. Oh, we almost lost Gorby again. I think he's been at one health so many times. Him and Aqua have like taken turns like almost dying. It's a rough life being an assault when I use them like that. Alright, what's this next group? Side flashbangs are good. Oh. We're building one right now. Maybe I'll build a second one. They're not insanely expensive. A lot of spam today. I wonder what the deal is. Why there's so many bots out today? Thanks, Chrono. Damage twice normal flashbangs. That's pretty interesting. Maybe I'll try that. Not sure the sniper's ever gonna have line of sight around here. Alright, what is it? Wow. Another Muton Elite pack. I can see at least three. Brought the sniper down from flying too. It's annoying. Right. We still don't have any cover that actually faces the correct direction. Pretty far back at the moment. We can maybe run away. I don't know if we can get to these. I can get to there. That's not a very good location. I might be able to get there. No, this is directly backwards. This one tile short. Be able to get to there. We're gonna have to go back to here. We could hunker here, but it's gonna get grenade. I think I move back and smoke it. Maybe even command smoke. So or command hunker instead. And what does everybody else do? Overwatch this from here, perhaps. Study that weapon. Overwatch there. Move back to there. No, I can't. I can move there. That doesn't help. Still no cover facing the right direction. Perhaps there with the hunker. Concealment would be really nice. Alright, what are we doing with the fucking medic? Oh, alright. I might not be able to smoke this. I might have to hunker everybody instead. That's pretty bad. It's getting rolled on a number of times, and only hardcover. Might be able to get far enough back from there. That actually ought to be far enough back. Okay, I need the actual highlight, please. It says it gets everyone, but I can no longer see the cursor, so I don't actually know if that's true. There we go. There's the cursor. Alright, not dense smoke. The scout's gonna get pounded this turn. Yeah, it's a double move, it's good. It's fine. It's less fine. Is there still a Mutant Elite? You now get the benefit of the Blood Call. Normally Blood Call doesn't mean anything, but the extra movement's actually a pain here. Okay, he can't see the medic, that's what I cared about. And he sees the scout. Okay, 20%. Alright, what can we do? Can kill some stuff in here, I hope. Can I get a rocket out to there? I actually can get a rocket to the two pieces there. I don't think there's any follow-up on that. Because my follow-up is sniper plus assault, and I don't think they're in range. So maybe I save that rocket, and instead I try to grenade. Because this tree would be good. We could kill this guy if we could see him. Actually, that's not true. I do have limited follow-up from here. So if I were to move the scout again, move him to here, and then we could move the infantry to there, or the gunner. The gunner up to here actually has sight too. I take it back. We have follow-up. We can maybe kill some of those. All right, let's do that. Right there. Good. What are the perks on this Mutant Elite? This is going to be the nasty one. It's a sentry with covering fire. Okay. Oh, we're going to have to run that. To where? To there? Okay. Alright, Luminous, there, 69s, okay, under CF to here, also 69s, we need to make those higher. Alright, let's holo, one with more HP, that one, nice, let's hit it, can we one shot that now? What's my crit chance on it? It's gotta be pretty high. 98. If we hit it, it dies. Nice. Alright, who has Executioner? It's the Sniper. Sniper's at a 92% though. To hit that. 8 damage. Probably kill it. Good. Kind of a wasted move then, I guess, on Kondrasiak, because they would kill him with two other guys. I was expecting to take more shots than that. Where's my medic? Still too slow to do anything. Can we get a smoke grenade over there? No, we'd have to be closer. That's ugly. Is the scouts just in hardcover with three mutants running at it? Not thrilled about that. Fuck. Actually, that's pretty bad. I can get killed by those three mutants. There's nowhere I can hide in either. Like, if I'm out in the open on this character, he probably dies. How close would I have to be to get the smoke grenade there? Two more tiles. I can maybe do it from here. I don't know if that's actually two tiles closer though. The diagonal makes it longer again. There's nowhere to hide to do this. Maybe I could command him out. I could command him out. Or command him to a hunker. Where does he go if I command him, though? He probably can't go too far back. A hunker likely gets me grenaded. That would be unfortunate. You guys won't know why that number was so big yesterday, Blue, right? It's because the sniper had bring him on. And there were 7 plus enemies on the field. So that's the biggest number you're ever going to see from a sniper. Some talk about big crits yesterday.
Heading to that location.
Oh, come on. I can no longer see to command the scout. Alright, well, we just made our decision for ourselves. No, it only had 7. 7 is what it caps at. No, I know there's 20 enemies. I'm saying that the damage mod from Bring 'Em On caps at 7 enemies. So the most amount of damage you're going to get from Bring 'Em On is at 7 plus enemies, which is what we had yesterday. Alright, I'm worried about this scout. Also worried about this pathetic smoke grenade that didn't hit anything it needed to. Okay, panic though is here is okay. It depends if it gets grenaded now or not. Sucks, but it's fine because it could have killed the scout. Okay. Alright, ugly round, but fine. Can blow his tree up. We'll flank him here. It's decent. Too bad. I'd like to holo that. Because I can't. I'm surprised it's as bad as this, honestly. Come on, fuck on. 280s, huh? No problem, just missing both. Alright, plan B. Dangerous with this guy's health. Sniper can't see anything. A little scary. Guess we have 4 shots on it. Let's try here. Is he gonna hit a smoke grenade? Did that miss again? about as lower level group we can bring on a mission like this. This has been a struggle, and we may lose someone still. Reload. Watch. Good. First time I've been happy to see enemies run in a while. And that's pretty damn close for an assault to be missing shots. I mean, that was a six tiles. Max level assault. Wasn't hollow targeted, and I was using rapid fire, but that's pretty bad. Basically means I have to be point blank every single time to get any use. Alright, we don't have any medkits left. We have a battle scanner left. I think we have a battle scanner left. Yeah, one. Alright, let's see if we get any sight out of this. Particularly, what is the command pack would be nice to know. Double outsider. Sniper sees fucking nothing. Story of this mission. This is why I don't like stationary snipers. Gotta wait on those mutons and then get the outsiders. I mean, the problem is we no longer have the hit points to deal with an outsider firing on us at all. So we have to be extremely careful. And this medic has been so slow. Been out of range of everything I wanted to do with the medic this entire mission. Tons are still running. I take it back about being pleased about that. Do I aggro the outsiders now? The tons are going to turn right around. This is my last turn of squad sight, though. Which outsider do I see? Is it the big one or the little one? It's the big one. See ya, Colonel. I don't have long-range cover removal anymore. That means I'm brawling with him. The medic actually somewhere useful. Yeah, kinda. Alright, I guess we will take this shot. Wait, I don't have any. I thought I had another grenade. Fuck. Rookies, you're so bloody pathetic. I don't have running gun up. Why did I do that this turn again? What reasoning was I thinking about? Why was I so fucking dumb? I can suppress one of them, I guess. Is this a flank? Oh, that's a flank. Alright. Mobinize, you need to do some work here. We need it to die. So, how do we do that? Hollow target it? Close. I could still run and gun it to there. I prefer not to. This is a close thing with this group. It's three nasty packs. Well, two nasty packs and the outsiders. Okay, double move. Okay, no blood call. Good enough. Sniper can't see anything. My fucking god. What does it take, sniper? What does it take for you to see something?
Yes, sir.
Not that, apparently. Could run to there and shoot that one, but then I can't suppress the other one. I can suppress from here, though. I lose line of sight from here. We never had it. Alright, I can guarantee to kill one. We just need to kill this light, the low HP one. Oh, I can actually see one on the sniper. Is it the right one? It is the right one. Alright, where is the scout? We need holo targeting.
Heading there now.
Perfect.
Negative ammo. Pop it. Shot wide.
Well, there's 12 kind of ridiculous aliens. For of those 12 aliens, 8 of them were Mutant Elites. Kind of ridiculous. 35 days on Gorby. It's the longest wound time I think we can get at this point in the game. After advanced repair. Alright, battle scanners. Good. 20 Illyrium. It hardly feels worth it for 20 Illyrium and 6 mil for like an hour. That's so like low yields. Alright, spin the wheel. Sure. Stressman failed. I actually need the side labs open. So some guys I need to test. Some snipers that I need to test. Notably. Krugzar. And Spence 3 days away. How long do we have? 1 day. And then we have a bunch of the psionic crowd that needs to be tested. Durand is ready in 2. The other guy's potentially ready now. Let's see if I can find him. It's a scout and a rocketeer. No. Still fatigued, I'm just not seeing him. There's skunk. Yeah. So I need the spots in the silo. Alright, spin the wheel. Did I get enough Illyrium for another Firestorm? 90. Not yet. Okay, let's get a second Psy Grenade. We need something for lower level groups versus that. Versus those types of guys. Plasma project. Good. We want to get 2 plasma weapons. Or not weapons, but damage items. Which, of course, I don't know what they're called. Which means I'm going to be spending the rest of my life looking through this shit. Plasma Stellarator. 20 Illyrium each. Alright, that's 40 Illyrium gone. More gene mods. Yeah, I'm having trouble deciding what I want for gene mods, honestly. Like, I don't want to just keep throwing gene mods on people who don't need them. I mean, it would be nice, I guess, to have adrenal neurosympathy. How long is that? Wait, 5 days. 6 days. Do I want to wipe Kuba out for 6 days? No, I have that second defense coming up. Jumpy legs on scouts? Possibly. I don't know which scouts I want to use, though. I don't know what scouts I want to keep as scouts. I lost them, my other max level scout just recently. Is Gemicurb's going to be a scout forever? I feel like Secondary Heart would go a long way on scouts. Might be nice. 24 meld, huh? It's quite expensive. Considering it's 6 for the eyes. How long? 7 days. Alright, troll. Let's try it. That's pretty expensive. This is a really expensive gene mod. We'll see how I like it. Alright, Brian failed. Any of the guys I need out yet? They're all about sergeant level. Days. Where are you, Annette? I know you're in here somewhere. One day, okay. Here's that other mission that I haven't been wanting to do. This is the terror mission in Mexico, which is probably meaning I'm gonna have to rebase assault fucking Mexico. I didn't want to do that. I don't think you can pull them out of the gene lab, right? Oh, you're talking to Psylab. No, I can't. I mean, I can't shoot this down clearly, so it's gonna be just let it land and go. Command Overwatch over Egypt. Can't do that either. Oh shit, that's Redford. We're not gonna shoot down an outsider with an overseer with three whatever it is. Do I have to capture the overseer as well or just shoot him down? Alright, one more really annoying mission. Waterfront. Okay. Bring a scout. Let's bring a rocketeer. Let's bring a sniper. Let's bring a second sniper. Bring a gunner. Let's bring an infantry. What are we gonna not bring? Need a medic. Guess we're not bringing an engineer, huh? Not bring a pathfinder. Just so fucking godlike though, pathfinders. Not bringing an engineer, huh? Means all my cover removal gets done by the rocketeer. Alright. Let's try it. Oh, but at least my battle scanner is not bringing an engineer. That doesn't actually sound that good to me. Maybe I do bring Kuba. My Reaper rounds. Oh, I have them on already. So what am I looking for? I'm looking for a targeting module. Okay. Kate. She's almost ready to upgrade. As soon as I get that plasma rifle, it's coming. Just not there yet. I know Kuba is psionic now, but I only have two narrow gun links, so it goes to the snipers because they're willpower. It's less likely they'll panic because they're further in the back, so it's better to get the gun sight on Kuba, who is also Overwatch. She doesn't have Executioner, so it just works out better if I have the three items to give it in that order. know what I want in this last item. I think I'm not bringing a mech on this one. In which case, what? Another battle scanner? Flashbang? Yeah, that means I need an engineer still, which is fine. Cover removal tends to be good on this type of map. And we'll go with alien grenades, and a shadow device, storm gun, movement, titan armor, I think. Alright, picking up double snipers instead of sniper mech for this. I don't know how I feel about that. It's a pretty solid squad though. High levels, all of them. I don't know that I'm gonna get any rescues though.
Strike one. Prepare for landing. We're going to be putting down in Mexico